In this video, we'll see about figure of eight suturing, which is especially important to close wounds after your extraction, right? To control bleeding from the extraction sockets, right? So you can see here, this is the extraction socket, and this is the buccal side, this is the lingual side, and this is the mesial side, and this is the distal side, right? So in and around the extraction socket, there are four interdental papillas, two on the buccal side, two on the lingual side, right? So on the buccal side, this is the mesial interdental papilla and this is the lingual distal interdental papilla. On the lingual side also, this is the mesial one and this is the lingual one. So first you have to engage the buccal side mesial interdental papilla, right? Like this. And after that, you have to engage the mesial papilla on the lingual side, like this. Right? So after engaging lingual mesial interdental papilla, you have to come on to the buccal side again and engage the distal papilla, right? Like this. And again, you have to come on the lingual side to engage the distal papilla on the lingual side, like this. Okay? So after this, you have to again come on to the buccal side to the mesial interdental papilla. We have, this is the long end and this is the short end. Short end is on the buccal side at the mesial interdental papilla. So you have to suture with that one. You can go for any knot, right? I will go with the surgeon's knot. So like this, you can see here, there is complete 8 number formation here, right? So if I draw, like this, right? First I have gone like this, then I again came to the buccal side distal one and again lingual side distal one, right? And I am suturing with your lingual side distal one and buccal side mesial one. So it will complete the 8 number. Okay, that is what exactly what I have done here, right? So this is about interdental figure of 8 suturing. You have to complete the knot. Okay, after that you can go on cutting the knot, right? So this is about figure of 8 suturing.